Now let's turn to the state of the race. Tuesday, CNN and the Des Moines Register are hosting the last debate before the Iowa caucuses. Democratic voters considering the candidates in the midst of tensions with Iran and the looming Senate impeachment trial. Joining me now to discuss all of this is Democratic presidential candidate Andrew Yang. So good to have you on. Thank you, sir. Let's start with Iran. Officials there are pushing back on U.S. evidence that it was their missile that shot down a Ukrainian plane, killing 176 passengers. How would you handle the situation right now if you were president?
75% of Americans want nothing to do with war in Iran. I believe that killing General Soleimani was a mistake, and we need to do everything we can to de-escalate tensions in the region and pursue diplomatic solutions. It's a terrible tragedy that that jet was shot down and that so many lives were lost. That's just one reason why we have to come back to the table with Iran and let them know we have no interest in disproportionate provocations that elevate hostilities.
Let's talk about impeachment now. We expect the House Speaker, Nancy Pelosi, to send the articles of impeachment to the Senate soon. Is it time to move this forward?
I believe it is. We need to get on with the business of solving the problems that got Donald Trump elected and present a positive vision that Americans can get excited about. The more we talk about Donald Trump, even in the context of impeachment, it's good for Donald Trump, and it's going to make it harder to beat him in the fall. So to me, we should move forward with impeachment proceedings because that was resolved in the House and should head to the Senate.
Well, you know what the House, they want witnesses, right? Nancy Pelosi is saying there should be witnesses. She wants to make sure it's fair. But do you believe the Senate needs to call witnesses in their trial?
Well, it should be a fair trial, and it should be in the hands of the Senate to call witnesses that are appropriate. But to me, at this point, the House has done its job, and the trial should be in the hands of the Senate. I think forestalling at this point doesn't serve anyone's interests.
Listen, there are a couple of things I don't envy about you guys out on the campaign trail. The schedule, you have to put up with a lot, but you've got to raise a lot of money. Your campaign reported a fourth quarter fundraising haul of $16.5 million. You met the donor requirements, but not the polling requirements for next week's debate. Will you change your strategy at all?
Well, we're optimistic that there'll be new polls that show that we're growing here in New Hampshire and around the country. But at this point, we're so close to voting that we can make our case directly to voters in Iowa and New Hampshire and Nevada and South Carolina. And like you just said, we raised $16.5 million last quarter, so we have the resources to go through the primary season into Super Tuesday and into the spring. We are in it to win it, and we'll be here the whole way.
Yeah, so you set me up for my next question because I want to put up this new Monmouth poll. It's out of New Hampshire today, and it has you polling at 3%. But when you dig into those numbers, really, you're the only candidate in that poll whose net favorability has gone up overall since May. Are voters still just getting to know you, you think?
You know, I just had an event tonight, latest in a series of events here in New Hampshire, and the crowds are bigger than ever. The energy is electric. The vast majority of voters have not determined who they're going to support in February. We are growing and growing, and we're going to peak at the right time when voting starts. This field is still very unsettled, and that's right there in the numbers in the polls.
As you know, there are a number of billionaires in this race. Tom Steyer is now the sixth candidate to qualify for the debate just hours ago after two new polls show him at double digits in Nevada and South Carolina. Steyer spent over $25 million on television ads in those states. How do you keep your message amplified when you have to compete against that kind of money?
Well, to me, the best possible source of contributions is the American people. We raised all this money with zero corporate PAC money, all grassroots donations. And I think if you have a lot of money, it can give you a bump or a boost, but it can't get you past a certain point because advertisements get annoying and irritating rather than helpful if you see too many of them from the same person. So I'm really excited about getting our case out to the American people through your friends, your neighbors, your family members. That's how we're seeing this growth here in New Hampshire and around the country. People listen to other people first and foremost, not advertisements.
Andrew Yang, always a pleasure. Good luck out there. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Don. See you back in New York soon. Appreciate you, brother.
It is a last debate before the first vote, and it's only on CNN. The top Democrats head to Iowa for a live CNN presidential debate in partnership with the Des Moines Register, Tuesday night, 9 Eastern, only on CNN.